Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel startuplanes.com. I'm Namrata and I'm taking interviews of the CEOs and founders of several innovative startups in India. In today's interview, I'll be talking to Mr. Sparsh Bansal, the COO of MyRupeezy. Mr. Sparsh, along with Mr. Arman Jaiswal, the director, and Mr. Aryan Mishra, the CEO, founded this company. Talking about the company, MyRupeezy is the first e-commerce platform where one can shop both online as well as offline. Sounds interesting? Let's get into the video.
Hello sir, good afternoon. Thank you for joining today. I'm Namrata, I'll be taking your interview. If you could kindly introduce yourself to the audience.
Yeah, sure. Hey, my name is Sparsh Bansal and I'm working as a CEO in this organization. I've done BTech and got experience around 5 years in this corporate sector. I have worked with many big firms and it's a big opportunity for me to introduce myself as one of the company owners. So I would like to first of all thank Startup Plans for providing me this opportunity. There are two more rulers which are heading this organization, Mr. Arman Jaiswal, who is the director of this company, and Mr. Aryan Mishra, who is the CEO of this organization. So basically we are the three musketeers here. But unfortunately, I just want to inform you here that Mr. Aryan has built the basic foundation of this company, but he is not well right now. He strategized all the operation framework when we were struggling and led us to create this viable environment. But however, due to some personal mishappenings in his life, he has not been keeping well since January this year and is not able to participate in any of the company decisions. I am mentioning his name because he is the one who gave all learnings to me and we were able to receive our seed funding. His present status is not good and even I am handling his professional networks, LinkedIn profile, etc. I wish for his speedy recovery. That's all about me and my three musketeers.
Same here. Also, how did you come up with the idea of the startup?
Well, frankly speaking, this idea has shared to me with the other two owners of this company. I'm just making this dream come true, which we saw together. You will not believe that I had also asked the same question. Then I got to know that this idea was in their head since college days. But unfortunately, at that time, it was in their head only. We can't be able to realize it and we can't be able to express it in the market. So last year, with all our hope, we had launched in the market. Not only this, this is just the starting. Soon our medical and food, both the application will be live in the market, which is also the gem with totally new ideas and creativity there.
Okay, so how difficult was it in the beginning to start?
Well, in early stage, I still remember our first meet with my shopkeeper. Frankly speaking, we have started our startup in the tier 2 cities like Lucknow, Varanasi and Prayagraj. So if we compare with metro cities, it's a bit difficult to run in these cities. But still, hard work pays off and right now we acquire some market in these cities. And people started trusting us. The best part is that because in tier 2 cities, people don't trust new things, but somehow with our efforts, we made them believe that this initiative is for them, for the support of Atmanirbhar Bharat. Another difficult part is that to onboarded shopkeepers in our platform. As a new platform, shopkeepers don't feel safe to try new things. Many negative thoughts come into their mind, but we make them believe to trust us. And right now we have got a pool of more than 25,000 plus shopkeepers and it's keep on increasing. So it's a huge achievement.
Right. So was there an existing market gap that your product had to fulfill?
Yeah, actually, I just want to tell it that gap in the market is that two-way communication gap between the shopkeepers and the customers. Due to COVID, many shopkeepers are facing a loss in their daily income. So we are here to cover that loss. Not only that, we are providing all the products to the customer within few hours on the same day itself. So right now, we are providing e-commerce products within few hours.
Okay, so if you had to explain your business model in layman term for me to understand or the audience to understand, how would you do that?
Well, this is some tricky question, but I would like to give it accordingly. So right now we are India's first e-commerce company where people can do offline and online shopping simultaneously. Our business model is lies that we are in the support of Atmanirbhar Bharat and want to help those shopkeepers which have lost income due to COVID. And we want to explore that products which people are not aware that these products that they can find in their own city only. A basic example is that if I'm living in Allahabad, Prayagraj, so first of all, I will not search in my own city. I will search in that the thing is that this product is lies online or not. So our main motive is that to provide any e-commerce product within few hours on the same day itself so that the customer could not need to wait two or more days. Moreover, a customer can buy our products while visiting to the shops which are tied to us for offline shopping. So that's why we are promoting offline and online both. Offline for those customers who still not believe in online services. In every billing from us, whether it's offline or online, a customer will be getting an additional cashback also in terms of rewards.
Okay, so what are the services or products that you're offering?
Well, we have all the products of e-commerce with 10 different categories, just like first category are is fashion and apparel. Second category is footwears. Third category is electronics and appliances. Fourth category is mobiles and computer. Fifth category is fight pandemic. Sixth category is books, toys, games and baby products. Seventh category is sports, fitness, bags and luggage. Eighth category is home, kitchen, pets and furniture. Our ninth category is cake, sweets and confectioneries. And the 10th, which is a most major one, which we are getting a lot of orders, is our grocery. Because in every house, grocery is required and we can't live without groceries. So in each categories, there are more subcategories depending on the clarification of their products. So in total, we had got more than 5 lakhs plus product, and that to the confirmation by our dedicated shopkeepers.
Okay. So who are the targeted customers for your product?
Well, I just want to explain that the targeted customers of our product is all the e-commerce platform, who all the e-commerce customer who are using the e-commerce platform. So why don't they go in our e-commerce platform? Because if I'm delivering that product within few hours, so there's no need to wait anyone for 2 days or 3 days. So the best part is that if I'm staying in Allahabad or if I'm in Lucknow, I order any product. Suppose I've ordered my mobile. So the best irony is that mobile will get delivered to them within 2 to 3 hours. So that customer can check the mobile if he or she is facing any type of issue also. He can address to us and that will be rectified within a day. So our customer don't need to wait just like that we are waiting right now online orders for 2 days, 3 days, 4 days. In the pandemic situation also, we have faced many different type of this thing. But right now, we are just here to enroll this thing.
Great. Also adding to your what you were saying that the customers don't have to wait. What are the other reasons why the customer should choose your services?
Well, I have got the best part is that we have got different types of service. The most important thing is that I just want to explain is that our first is post your requirement. We have come a special feature of post your requirement in which our customers can submit their specific requirement through application and website. Their requirements will be fulfilled within next 6 working hours. So this post your requirement have built up. This is the first thing any company have built up post your requirement. So for example, if I am a customer and I need 5 kg atta, so I can post this requirement either on my application or either on my website. That requirement will come up to me and it's our duty to fulfill that within 6 hours. The next feature is that list your product. We have one special feature where the customer can share the list of product which required to their specific shop. And once the product gets confirmed from the shopkeeper, it will deliver to the customer as soon as possible. So here I just want to give you a simple example. Well, we all here goes for a shopping, but we have got one fixed shop where we used to buy each and every product. So similarly, list your product works like that only. And the best thing is that we have given the best platform of offline shopping, because I still believe, because I have got my own prior experience that I have started my startup in this tier 2 cities, people don't easily trust online. So I have sought the solution of that also. I have told them, just go and visit to our onboarded shops and get the product. You will get the rewards at that time also. So the best thing is that we have come across in offline shopping also. These are the things which we are getting attractive to our customers, so that our customers should choose our product, our company to get it done.
Okay. So what are the three things that separate you or make you better than your competitors?
Well, I guess at this answer I've already given you in my last edit in that. So basically the first is the post your requirement, which I've already told you, and the second is the list your requirement, and the third is in offline shopping.
Okay.
Yeah, just in the previous answer I've added in that.
Right. So if I'm a job applicant, if I'm willing to work for your firm, why should I work?
That's a nice question. We are a startup, and right now acquiring a market at a rapid rate. So a person can see a better future ahead. As the company will grow, more opportunities will come. Moreover, we try to create a healthy atmosphere around us, so a person should always seem to enjoy in working. Employee growth and benefits are also important for the company to grow in the market.
Okay, so if you are not doing this business right now, what else would you be seeing yourself doing?
Well, might be I was also working for any of other corporate companies. In the initial phase, every company was a startup only. Company acquires a big name in the market once they get funding, so that they can buy their range in all over the world. So yeah, obviously I was also working for any of the big corporate firms.
Right. So I want to know if there is any particular service or product you constantly require to run your own business.
Yes, actually right now we are just wondering to get it, I just call the seed funding or funding. We are just waiting to get it seed funding so that we should explore our market more, because our food application and medical application is also on the developing stage, so that will also going to launch soon in the market, and that too with a different idea and creativity. So that the best part is that we are all set to go in the market, just we all are lacking behind some sort of cheap funding and funding here.
So while choosing vendors, what are the parameters you evaluate them?
Well, if I tell you frankly, we are right now open for any vendors. We are not here to choose any parameters, because we are not in that stage right now. We want that our company should get explored and people should know about it, that yeah, this thing is that new thing have come in the market, which is totally in the support of Atmanirbhar Bharat. I just want that companies are coming from outside India and they are ruling in India. So India have got a vast range of network and market, and the best part to do business is in India only. That's why our foreign companies first come and visit to India, so that they should explore our market. So is that I'm just waiting for that only, so that I should explore my market more, at least in India terms. And I should tell and support that, yeah, this company is basically for purely for Indian and for Atmanirbhar Bharat.
Right. Also, have you planned any short-term goals or long-term goals for your company?
Well, in recent plans, we have already hit 3 cities. So we have started from UP East. And as you already know, maximum startups start from metropolitan cities, not from tier 2 cities. Once they acquire market, Then they target to tier 2 cities because there's a chance of success in metropolitan is higher if we compare to tier 2 cities. But here we had already changed the whole theory. We had started from tier 2 cities, get a better response from there, and now we are planning to go live in metropolitan city. So if we compare, there is a chance of success is relatively higher. Moreover, our next two applications, that is, I've already told, medical and food, are on also on the process to get live in the market. So in long-term plan, we are covering every aspects of the market, and the first target is to get productive in every metropolitan cities first, and then to the other cities of India.
Right. I want to know something about your funding scene. Like, have you received funding from external sources, or are you planning to get funding in the coming years, months?
Well, I just want to tell you frankly is that we are planning also, and we have got some responses also from the good VCs also. But unfortunately, due to COVID, as you already know, all the things is lag behind now. But the thing is that right now we are looking for the vendors, and we can wide our range in different cities. So yes, we are looking for the vendors, and if once we get our vendors, then we will be planning to expand it more.
Right. Lastly, I would like to know your thoughts about Startup Planes. Like, you were already talking about Startup Planes. Any concluding message, anything to say?
Well, just want to add it here that thanks Startup Plans have given me this opportunity to address me and my company on my own behalf. We have got a staff of more than 25 people working there, and it's my privilege to get it done. It's my privilege to share all the thoughts about being as a company owner. So yeah, it's a very good opportunity Startup Plan have provided me to introduce myself and my own company. So yeah, I've just been looking for a better positive response from our side. That's all.
Well, that would bring an end to this interview today, but it was lovely talking to you and getting to know about your business.
Yeah, same here. It was really nice having a conversation with you.
Thank you for joining.
Thanks a lot. Have a great day.